crowd really hostile towards him. He's got to come here and prove that he's a champion against the undefeated Xolisani Ndongeni, the local boy.
Yeah, Godfrey, of course, the experienced one. 28 fights, 24 wins against a young man. He's been growing up the ladder, fast and furious.
He's only 22 years of age, Xolisani Ndongeni. But very, very popular in this part of the world. He is rated number two, Brian, because number one in the ratings is Jasper Soroka, who injured his shoulder and couldn't challenge the champion Godfrey Nzimande. That is why this man, Xolisani Ndongeni, found himself here. And as we came in, Brian, this afternoon, we heard the crowd screaming.
Big right hand from Nzimande.
Yes, a big right hand, but the crowd was screaming, and they knew, obviously, rooting for their man, Xolisani Ndongeni.
Well, he's got to do it first, Peter. Again, some experience in Nzimande. Nzimande's the kind of guy, he's been around for a while, fought the best fighters, beaten some of the best, lost to some of the best, and he gets up for the job when he needs to.
Right, gets up to this to Brian, and two of those losses came against Xolisani Ndongeni and also Jasper Soroka, the man who's rated number one for his title.
But he's
only three losses for the champion Godfrey Nzimande.
Yeah, and Ndongeni is a good puncher, but obviously his opposition hasn't been as good as Nzimande.
And it's all on the challenger right now, Ndongeni, in the black trunks.
Ndongeni's got that strange style. He jabs and he draws you in, but those hands up it low. Nzimande lands with a good right hand.
No doubt, Brian. Nzimande, a very, very experienced boxer. 32 fights, only three losses.
Nzimande misses there with a left and right combination.
Now he hasn't quite settled, the champion, Godfrey Nzimande, as the challenger.
Well, it's one for you, one for me right now.
A very, very good opening round there for Xolisani Ndongeni. And as I said, the champion seems to be a little bit tight. Just listening in on the...
Godfrey Nzimande's trainer, Nick Durant.
Drop your right here. Come back on the hooks. You must have caught him as left hook now, the side jab. If it landed there, he was gone. Okay. So concentrate on the stiff jabs now coming forward. Double the jab. Boom, boom. Drop to here. Come back on the hook.
Clear instructions there for the champion, Godfrey Nzimande, from his trainer, Nick Durant. He says straight left. And catch him with the left hook. He says if you catch him with the left hook, he will go down. But the challenger, Xolisani Ndongeni, very, very confident, Brian. He's never lost as a professional.
Yeah, nine fights, nine wins. Very good record from the challenger. And seven by way of KO. So he's no slouch. Although, as you said, hasn't fought the caliber of opponent yet as the champion, Godfrey Nzimande.
Yeah, no, Godfrey Nzimande has been there with the best, Brian. The Makhales of this world, Jasper Soroka. Very, very good boxers. He lost his last fight, Brian, against the Talon Zlatikanin. In Hola Morocco, in Podriga, Montenegro.
Oh, great left hook, straight right from Godfrey Nzimande. And he hurt the challenger there, Ndongeni.
That's what trainer Nick Durant said to him. I said, if you can catch him good and well, you will drop your opponent.
Oh, the left hook definitely did the business.
of what Brian is at now. The challenger seems to be cut above his right eye. And we are only in the second round, Brian.
So I think Zimandi's power is deceiving as well, because he's got hand speed. And when he gets at the hand speed going, hand speed creates power. But Godfrey Zimandi gets caught now with a left hook.
And again it goes wide.
Oh, and a big right there from Ndongeni. Another right there from Ndongeni.
It's catching his hand.
Godfrey.
And the champion has got a hold, Brian.
The champion's holding on now.
He's not holding, Brian, so obviously he is still within his
big right hand from Ndongeni. He's got to be careful, because Godfrey Zimandi will catch him back. And the champion's in trouble here in round two.
And the crowd's going wild. Look at the crowd behind. Going wild, wanting their men to finish this fight in this round.
He's a big punch on Ndongeni. And he's hurt Godfrey Zimandi again. He's in trouble, Zimandi, as he comes back with his own left hook.
Ndongeni is caught upon the piece of right eye, Brian, and that happened in the first round. I thought that was a scar during the break, but it seems like it's a cut. A big, big round there for the challenger, Xolisani Ndongeni.
Big round here for the challenger.
Well, Brian, I would say he did shake the champion, but he didn't hurt him. The champion didn't seem to be hurt at all, because he didn't even attempt to hold his opponent. Look at that onslaught from the challenger.
Big right hand there. Godfrey and Zimandi almost knocked him down. He's definitely never fought 12 rounds before, so that's good advice, because if I was a champion, that's what I would do. Put on the pressure, make the challenger tired. Oh, but Godfrey and Zimandi has been hurt again.
Very, very funny, Brian, because I thought that the champion touched the canvas with his glove. Was that a knockdown?
Well, Peter, I would think it is a knockdown, because if your glove touches the canvas and you've been hurt, that's a knockdown. But unless the referee thinks you slipped and you fell over your feet, it's all the referee's discretion.
Yeah, and the referee for this fight, Alan Matakane, also a very, very experienced referee. But right now, it is a challenger, younger challenger, 22 years old, Xolisani Ndongeni.
Oh, he's showing no respect now to Godfrey Zimandi, the champion. He wants that title. He's the 22-year-old.
Nick Durant said to the champion, don't waste any punches. Don't punch when it is not necessary.
Big left hook from Nzimande.
He's coming back, the champion, now. He's taking everything that the challenger can throw. The question is, can Ndongeni take the punches from the champion, Godfrey Nzimande?
Well, Godfrey's taken a better shot so far than the challenger, because the challenger on Ndongeni been shook more times than the champion has. So far the champion has taken the better shot, and defensively the champion's better. So on Ndongeni, he's going to need to pick his hands up. He's a good puncher, and he's throwing a lot of bombs, but he needs to get more defensive as on Ndongeni if he wants to win the title.
Yeah, he's throwing bombs right now, Brian. And the champion has taken them all well. Look at the combinations coming from the challenger, Xolisani Ndongeni.
Good combinations from Ndongeni. Drawing his man in with a jab. And another close round. It's almost one for you, one for me again. Boom, right uppercut from the challenger.
Godfrey Zimandi comes back now.
Oh. Good left kick there again from the challenger. Oh, Peter, let me ask you, how do you judge that run?
Well, a very, very close round, but I have to give it to the challenger, Brian, because he was the champion Godfrey Nzimande is still holding back. He's still holding back, Brian. He's still too early in the fight. They believe that the challenger cannot fight like this for the entire 12 rounds. They believe he will tie out, and they believe that they will knock him out.
You see the corner of the challenger. Well, there we see the slam action from round three. And Ndongeni, as you said, Peter.
There you go, Brian. He did touch the canvas with this glove, but obviously, Reverend Allen Matakani thought that was not from a punch when he went down. So there was no knockdown, according to the referee. As we move into round number four. And the younger challenger, 22 years old, Xolisani Ndongeni, still on the rampage, Brian.
Oh, he's hooked the champion now. The straight right left hook.
Champion Brian, very, very experienced. He can take punches. So far, he's taken everything that Xolisani Ndongeni has thrown at him.
So far, good performance here by the young man, Xolisani Ndongeni.
Two questions for him, Brian. Can he fight like this with entire 12 rounds? And can he take big, big punches if the champion, Godfrey Nzimande, decides to offload?
Well, he probably can fight at this pace for 12 rounds, Peter, because these guys are all in great shape. But to answer your second question, whether he can take Godfrey's left hook or not, well, only time will tell, because Godfrey's got a sneaky, fast little left hook, and that works for him. And the challenger's hands are very low, and he's very inexperienced. He's showing his inexperience right now. But in the same breath, he's landing a lot of punches. Oh, nice uppercut from the challenger.
Yeah, he's landing some bombs now, Brian. But the champion is still there, Godfrey Nzimande. Very, very experienced. 32 fights. Only 3 losses. And as you said, Brian, he's been up against a very, very good boxers.
Yeah, Godfrey's going to have to up his work rate, though. Otherwise, he's going to be falling behind on the rounds.
And the challenger seems to be having a problem with his right eye, Brian. He is cut above that eye. And seems to be having problems with the blood flowing into his right hand.
Oh, good left hook by Nzimande.
Yeah, the champion is coming back now, Brian. The challenger
is looking for big left hooks. The cut above the right eye, the challenger is bothering him.
Yeah, for that in a big time, Brian. He's trying to wipe away the blood from that right eye because he's probably having problems seeing out of that eye. And this is why the champion now must take advantage, Brian, and put pressure on the challenger.
Yeah, that's what he's doing.
Big right hand there from the challenger. He might be having a problem seeing, Brian, but that right hand of his.
Good right hand for Nzimande to end the round. And a good round for the champion, Godfrey Nzimande.
They've got to do that something quickly with that cut above the challenger's right eye. In fact, it's not a cut, Brian. It seems to be like a graze. A graze.
Yeah, it looks like a little graze.
Yeah, but whatever it is really troubling the challenger. Xolisani Ndongeni. Action from the slow-mo. Left hand there from the champion.
Yeah.
And just when you think that he was getting his way, the challenger came with his big right hand of his, slowing him down.
Well, if the challenger did win round four, he lost round five. So we pretty much packed an even fight here.
Round number five, at stake is the South African junior lightweight title.
And Godfrey Nzimande is coming with pressure.
Champion is Godfrey Nzimande. He's defending the title against Xolisani Ndongeni in the black trunks.
Good work from the champion now as he uses that jab.
Champion now, Brian, putting pressure now on the challenger.
Well, Godfrey Nzimande keeps fighting like he is now. He can make it an easy fight for himself because his hands up nice and high. He's putting on the pressure, and the challenger doesn't like it. The challenger's hands are very low, very inexperienced. You said, Peter, can he fight 12 rounds like he started off? Probably not. And I was the one that said he could. Champion looking a lot better here in round five.
That's the advice that the champion, Godfrey Nzimande, got from his corner. He was told that the challenger will soon tire. You just keep on doing what you have to do. And the young man will tire.
Good left hook from Nzimande. Ndongeni has a big problem with his defense. His hands are very low for a guy that's had 9 fights. Well, for any guy, really.
His hands are very low, Brian. And he gets away with it because now he has just stopped throwing punches. So it's very, very difficult to come in. Because as you do that, you are bound to face some barrage of punches from the challenger.
A good right off the cut from the challenger. But is it enough? Nzimande has won the first 2 minutes of the sixth round. The fifth round of his.
One thing that really works for the challenger, Brian, is that now he never stops throwing punches. Which is a good thing. He keeps on throwing punches, Brian. Look at that. That's it.
Great right hand from Ndongeni. Oh, another right hand.
Godfrey Nzimande just slowed down. He's not hurt, definitely. He's not hurt. But he keeps on coming forward.
Good left hook as well from Ndongeni.
The champion is getting nailed, Brian, but he keeps on coming forward. Another quick round for the challenger, for the side of Ndongeni.
He turned it around in the end. Look at them. They love their boxing in this part of the world, in the Eastern Cape, Buffalo City Metro. Wow, they really do love their boxing.
The arena is fully packed, Brian, in anticipation of Xolisani Ndongeni becoming the new South African junior lightweight champion. But he's got his work cut out. He's up against a very, very good champion, Godfrey Nzimande, 31 years of age. 32 fights, 28 wins, only three losses and one draw.
Well, the challenger at least wants to win this fight. He needs to try and make the champion go backwards a bit. And what the champion doing is the right thing coming forward. But good work there from Ndongeni.
For somebody really has only had 9 professional fights, Brian. Xolisani Ndongeni is fighting very, very well. We're in round number 6.
Yeah, he's fighting a good fight.
Scheduled for 12 rounds.
referee mustn't neglect his work right. If he wants to retain the title today, because it's all about the guy throwing the most punches and landing. And they're both throwing a lot of punches, but who's landing more is important. Good right hand from Nzimande.
Well, he's coming back now, Brian. He's really fighting with some peppers. Again, he's going to be very, very careful. So he continues to fight, Brian, and throw a lot of punches.
Yeah, good right hand from Ndongeni. Now we're in round six.
Good left jab there from the challenger.
Oh, it's amazing how the fight game is all about styles. Normally Ndongeni has his own way, but tonight the challenger's up. He's fighting a classy champion.
Great guys.
And he has a graze on his eye.
Guys, he got that burn as early as the first round. And in the fourth round, it seemed to be giving him some trouble, that graze.
And Zamani looking for that big bomb, overhand right.
The challenger now.
Oh, big punches from the challenger.
And the champion is missing and missing.
Oh, big from the challenger.
Oh, the challenger is landing. The champion is missing. Another good round for the challenger, Xolisani Ndongeni. And the crowd appreciating what they have seen. And still chanting the new, because even Progress chanting the new. We are now halfway through the fight.
Citroën DS3.
Citroën, creative technology.
Customized like never before from $199,900.
That look, it's that look, that beg for more look.
Because you're begging for more, South Africa. Now with any two large pizzas, you will get four free savory beg for mores. Debonair's Pizza. Everybody tuck in.
Fight. Box on, says referee Alan Matakane. Now can the challenger, Brian, continue to do exactly what he's been doing in the past six rounds? Avoiding the big punches from the champion, but landing.
Good left hook from Nzimande.
Nzimande is throwing some wild punches, Brian. He's been told that if he can land clean, the challenger is going to go down.
That right eye of the challenger is bothering him. He's wincing a lot there. And he's showing Nzimande.
No, stop.
And it's not good news for the challenger. Because he's showing the champion that the eye is bothering him. And an experienced fighter like Nzimande is picking it up and landing the bombs. Good right hand from Nzimande. Oh, good left hook from the challenger.
The challenger's landed a lot of punches, Brian. But as I said, he's yet to hurt the champion. He's shaking him, definitely, but he's not hurting the champion. And the champion is continuing. And it's going to be a question of whether Ndongeni can keep up the pace for the entire 12 rounds.
Eye of Ndongeni is bothering him a lot. But you gotta win fights, title fights, and big fights with cuts. That's what it's all about. He gets nailed with the right hand from Godfrey Nzimande.
He was nailed.
And Godfrey's hurt the challenger. But he's back. That's a good fight. A terrific fight. And what else did we expect, Daniel, in his London, in the South African title fight? They're all good fights.
Very, very good fight, Brian. And the crowd is equally knowledgeable.
Bombs from both fighters.
Nzimande trying to want to kick out the challenger. You can see the way he's punching, Brian.
He's doing the right thing, Nzimande, because he can see the challenger's eyes bother him, and he's putting him under pressure. And that's he's finding the right fighter, Nzimande. The challenger needs to pick up his game now. Okay, in round seven, land a few more punches. Did well in the earlier rounds, the challenger.
He's punching and holding, Ndongeni, that's what he's doing, frustrating the champion. A good round there for the champion, I think.
On the scorecard. Definitely a good round for the champion. A good round for the champion. The eye is bothering the challenger.
Could now this be the turn of events, Brian? This is now where the fight is turning. Round number eight. If you've just joined us, I'm Peter Leopeng, and I'm with my co-commentator, the legendary Brian Mitchell. And you're watching the South African junior lightweight title fight between the champion Godfrey Nzimande, the white trunks, against Xolisani Ndongeni in the black trunks. Ndongeni undefeated in nine fights, nine wins, seven KOs.
Yeah, thanks, Peter. But good afternoon of boxing, and this is a very entertaining South African junior lightweight title fight. The champion has come on strong in the last couple of rounds. And if Xolisani Ndongeni wants to keep an undefeated record, he's going to have to up his game now.
I think this is where the champion now believes that he will take charge. But now he's in the corner now.
Big punches from the challenger now.
Hey! Right, guys, let's go. Hey!
The champion, Brian, has been told that the challenger is bound to tire.
I think this is the stage now where he thinks he can take over
the champion.
Well, he does look like he's tiring a lot now as the challenger.
He's good punching, Brian, but he's not punching as effectively as he was in the earlier rounds. He's throwing one or two punches and he holds. But if that is the strategy that he has to adopt, to see the end of this fight, well, he will do exactly that.
Well, right now the champion is getting on top. Gets caught to the left hook, but he's coming forward. Nice combo from the challenger, Ndongeni.
Ndongeni is a very, very deceiving boxer, Brian. You may think he's tired, but just look how really he punches, catches the champion coming in. And out he goes.
Well, another close round. And Zamandi's putting on the pressure, but he's getting caught coming in.
Accurate punch is definitely coming from the challenger. And the crowd is still screaming, Brian, and they knew. And we're only in round number eight.
10 seconds to go. Good right there from Zamandi, the champion. The crowd respect it. And Nzimande has come on well in the last two rounds.
What a round, Brian. Who would you give it to?
I'll go Nzimande. Close round, but I think Nzimande with the pressure.
Round number nine. If you've just joined us, you've really missed out on a very, very great eight rounds in this junior lightweight contest between the champion Godfrey Nzimande, 31 years of age, defending his title against Xolisani Ndongeni.
Well, four rounds to go, Peter, and it's still really anybody's fight. First couple of rounds belong to the challenger, and the champion's made a strong comeback. His last four rounds are going to determine who wins this title fight. Or whether the champion retains his title, or the challenger stays undefeated.
The challenger pinning the champion in the neutral corner and coming away. Xolisani Ndongeni in the black trunks, trying to become the South African junior lightweight champion.
He's got work to do.
He's throwing bombs up high and he's really, really punching with bad intentions. Godfrey Nzimande.
Yeah, Godfrey's putting on the pressure. The challenge is falling out of his own feet.
Could he be tired, Brian?
Yeah.
Is this what they were talking about?
Yeah,
he said he couldn't.
He's tired, Peter, but I think it's more even the inexperience. He's at a different level now, you know. He's had 9 fights and Zimani's had 20 odd fights.
32 fights in fact, Brian. Very, very experienced Godfrey Nzimande. The crowd will cheer every punch that Xolisani Ndongeni lands.
Well, that's another thing, Peter, you know, how do the judges look at every round? You know, if Nzimande misses a punch, the crowd cheer. And if the challenger lands a punch, the crowd cheer. So, obviously, you're up against the crowd as well.
Yeah, we saw the challenger there falling in his own corner, Brian. With the amount of water that is in this corner.
Good left hook from Nzimande.
And Nzimande is putting pressure. Brian is really, really after the challenger. He believes he can knock him out, Brian. He believes that this is his time now. As the bell ends round number 9, 3 more rounds to go. Little round. Inside still very, very unhappy with the way the referee is handling this fight. He believes that the referee is not warning the challenger, and the crowd really booing Nzimande. Godfrey Nzimande is all out to nail the challenger. Can he find that punch to take him out? Because that's what he wants to do.
Well, yeah, I still think it's a pretty closest fight, Peter, that the champions come back the last couple of rounds very well. Challenger dictated with the middle rounds. And now it's whoever wins the next 3 rounds is going to be taking that South African title, either back to Johannesburg or keeping it locally.
The challengers continue to land whatever he can land. And getting the crowd excited. And now he holds. Okay. And the crowd appreciates that and say, keep doing what we have to do to win this fight.
And in fact, Peter, what BSA has done now is the new rules are, if you win the title, 3 defenses and you keep the belt where it used to be 5 defenses. And at one stage it was 1 defense or no defenses. So, I'm happy about that. In my day, it was 3 defenses of the South African title and you get a belt. So well done to BSA. I think that's a good rule. Guy doesn't have to wait 5 times to defend. After 3 defenses, you get to keep the beautiful belt that they're redesigning. But back to the action here. Godfrey Nzimande doing well in round 10.
He wants to knock out his opponent, but he believes that if he can catch Xolisani Ndongeni with 1 good punch, he will take him out.
Oh, there's a lot of water in the corner, and that's coming from the challenger, and he's slipping in his own water.
Slipping in his own corner, Brian. And the crowd is still continuing to chant, Brian. Trying really to keep their man on his feet. They believe that if he goes the full 12 rounds, he will be counted the new South African junior lightweight champion. That is a man in the black trunks, Xolisani Ndongeni.
Oh, we see a fanatical crowd singing. Olay, 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 olay. Brilliant stuff. Great crowd support. And, well, as the champion managed to claw his way back into this, it certainly looks like it in round 10.
The challenger plan is all over the show. He seems to be unsteady on his legs. But then this is how he's been fighting throughout. End of round number 10. They are cheering him, still shouting, and they knew. They want to see this fight going the full distance because they believe that the challenger will win.
Saying that the other guys won 8 out of 10 rounds, I think it's just to motivate his fighter with 2 rounds to go, because he knows it's East London, a local boy, does get a little bit of favoritism because of the crowd. You know, the judges are definitely swayed by the crowd from time to time, but good work from the challenger here in round 11.
Yeah, he's pinning the champion in his own corner. And that is after the champion hit on the break. Round number 11. Can the fight go the distance? And if it does, who will be count the South African junior lightweight champion?
At this stage, it looks like the fight will be going the distance. He's managed to maintain.
And again, Brian. As you say that, this is boxing, anything is possible. One punch can change the complexion of this fight.
Yeah, interesting to see how the judges have it right now. But it is a close fight.
It is a close fight, Brian. And the judges will have their work cut out. Babaza, Mbini, and Matakane.
Round 11, the South African junior lightweight title fight. Godfrey and Nzimande defending their title against Xolisani and Ndongeni. And who wants it most, Jay, the last 2 rounds, the penultimate round, round 11.
Penultimate round with a minute left. The challenger, Xolisani and Ndongeni, was not expected to still be standing. He's never been in round number 11 in his short career of 9 fights. But tonight he's hoping to turn the tables on the champion, Godfrey Nzimande, an experienced boxer with 32 fights, 28 wins, 3 losses, and only 1 draw. Big right hand there from the challenger Ndongeni.
Good left hook from Ndongeni as well. And another good right hand from the challenger. Oh, he's winning round 11, the challenger.
He's turning it around, Brian. The round that was very close now is turning in the favor of the challenger.
So that's what I think he's done a few times here tonight, Peter. He's turned a close round into his own round, the challenger. And the judges might swing it his way with all those close rounds that are going his way.
The champion, Godfrey Nzimande, is going to have to do something very special. At least he needs to knock down his opponent
leaving for him to have a chance. Let's look. Look at this right hand there from the challenger, pushing back the champion.
You see, as much as the challenger is holding, he's also landing a lot.
Really what works for the challenger, Brian, is the fact that he just throws punches, Brian, just keeps on throwing punches. And there's the crowd, confident that they're going to have a new South African champion in the junior lightweight division. Can Godfrey Nzimande knock out his opponent, inexperienced Xolisani Ndongeni?
Well, Ndongeni has landed good punches throughout the fight, and so is Nzimande. We'll know in the next 3 minutes who the judges fancies, in the next 2 minutes.
He's landing, Brian. He might not be having the champion, but he is landing Xolisani Ndongeni. And these are round winning points.
Now, as I said, Peter, I think if Ndongeni does win this title, it would be because he's won the last minute of a lot of the rounds with heavy punches. Nzimande's kind of dominated minute or two of the round, or the first half of the round, let's call it, and then taken his foot off the gas, where Ndongeni has come back towards the end of every round and maybe impressed the judges.
Yeah. If there's any problem really with the champion, Brian, that night, he's been looking for big punches the whole night. He hasn't really been letting his punches go. He's looking for big punches.
Yeah, and he's
the challenger. Look what he's doing right now. He's just landing punches. They might not be hitting the champion, but they're winning the rounds.
Yeah, and he's such a good boxer, Nzimande. So he's neglected his boxing skills, looking for the knockout.
The champion is very, very desperate now, Brian, leaving himself open. You can hear the crowd shouting, and they knew, and they knew. And with less than a minute left now in round number 12.
One minute to go. Less than a minute to go, and he believes he's won the fight on Ndongeni. He's still got to wait for the judges to decide that.
Nzimande, Brian, still trying desperately to come out with a big, big shot that will kick out the challenger, and he's missing.
But I think you called it, Peter. Nzimande's been looking for the knockout from round one, and he knows he did hurt his man early on, and that might have spoiled it for him, because he's definitely got the better boxing skills, but he's neglected them tonight by not using them and looking for the bombs.
Now you can see him now, Brian. He's been trying to go for big knockout punches. He is not just landing. And again, the challenger stealing the round right in the 10 seconds. And do we have a new South African junior lightweight champion?
Well, it'll be up to the judges.
Right, up to the judges, Brian. Judge Mabaza, Judge Mbini, and Judge Ntiao.
Ladies and gentlemen, this South African junior lightweight fight was scheduled for 12 rounds. It's gone the distance. We now go to the judges' scorecard. And we have a unanimous points decision. Judge Vabaza. We now go to the judges' scorecards, and we have a unanimous points decision. Yes. Judge Mabaza scores the fight 109-119. Judge Mbini scores the fight 110-119. Fight 109-119.
shot out. 1-1, 9, 109 on 2 tennis scorecards.
Yeah.
And 1-1-0, 1-1-9. Brothers, a shot out. Almost every round won by the challenger.
Yeah, I don't go with that, Peter. There's no way on my scorecard that I would have had it so far apart. You know, possibly the right man won, but not by that scorecard. Well, it's been a fantastic afternoon of boxing. Many flow at four down and see a Bonga Sia beats in Abirulani KO round two. Junior Landreid 6 round book. Kazali Malazi beat Jerome SATKO round two as well. Junior Bandewaid 6 round. September Fayer beat Wiseman Keng on points. Junior Landreid's Wanga Mshana beat Mundai Nshifo TKO round two.
And in the two.